Yeah, if you wouldn't mind closing that up, I'd give this an intro.
So you know the last guy that I was talking about, the director? There's a little bit of a twist and a bitter tone to it. I ended up dating him because I left the guy that I was with previously. Somebody that actually meant a lot. A previous boyfriend who I was in an open, long-distance relationship with, that I opened up, and I had said that everything would be okay. An open, long-distance relationship that I said would be okay, which I loved. And I really, really loved him, and as they say, it was truly, madly, deeply in love. And he was the artist, or agape. Agape is what you would call true love. It's not reliant on a type, and it usually occurs with a stranger, somebody that you meet by happenstance. Maybe you're running through the rain and they offer you an umbrella, or you find them on Grindr because they're at a local, they're a local sightseeing spot, and you end up having a beautiful, beautiful 2 days together before they go back to the town from whence they came. Establishing an open, long-distance relationship. You feel concern and care for the other partner. You're not jealous or possessive, and there's a healthy sexual relationship that you're willing to improve and work on. Who knows, maybe tomorrow I'll look back on another person I loved and consider them the epitome of agape. Maybe they were the love of my life, but I do know above all that this was real, and that's the thing about it, is you just know whenever it happens, and I completely threw it away. And I was too distracted by this monologue to try anything, so you guys are gonna, it's gonna be a mystery as to what he looked like. Since I'm such a good artist. But he truly was the artist. He went to Cornell and got a degree in fine arts, and he lives with his parents and makes sculptures. But no, he really was lovely, I promise. Now, would you mind, where's Marionette? Oh, that's okay, I'll put that. The next one was the British one. Just the British one. This was actually the longest relationship I've had in my entire life, and it was represented by the Greek form of love, storge, which is when you're not looking for love, but you're ready when you encounter it. It comes from a friendship, and it develops after commitment already exists. It's instinctual, and it makes sense, and the relationship itself is a little bit more functional than it is fun. James, the British one, oh here, I can do a little illustration. No, so in reality, he had long, wispy blonde hair and this skinny little body, but mostly, I'm not drawing him because the best part about that relationship, let's be honest, was his mother. She allowed us to drink all of the time. British mom's really great, hands-off kind of situation, introduced me to a lot of terrible things at a young age, but we started dating my freshman year, and it was out of necessity. I grew up in a very small town in the middle of the mountains called Evergreen, Colorado. Woo for that. And there were not a lot of options out there. I'm sure a lot of you understand if you did have some sort of romantic or sexual relationship in high school, getting into a relationship out of necessity, sometimes it just happens. You have to unload all that love and intimacy that's growing in your pubescent body and throw it on somebody else, and it worked for quite a few years. It worked to the point that when he graduated and went back to college in the UK, we continued talking. We weren't technically dating. We did the right thing and separated. But we also did manage to fuck each other every single break that he came back. So it was a long, drawn-out process, and one of the last ones of those, he proposed to me. I was 19 years old at the time, and I said yes. He was great. We knew each other had been a long time, and it made sense.
And what happened?
The love was storgic. It just made sense. He was there, I was there, and we both sort of wanted to do it. So we were engaged for 72 hours. We realized later that we had been maybe a little bit too drunk at the time of the proposal, and I was a little frustrated that I didn't have a ring. And so, as much as I would have appreciated a 10-carat double band. Oh, thank you.
10-carat double band.
And so that ended. All for the better, and I am no longer an engaged woman, but I can now say that I was. Who's ready for the last one? This is my army hammer. You've all seen Call Me By Your Name, right?
Yes!
Or at least heard way too much about it.
Yeah!
Give it up if you are a gay, male-presenting person that had a little bit of a Call Me By Your Name sort of experience in your young. I see you with the hand in the back there. It's the reason that Call Me By Your Name was so successful and why it existed in the first place was that it's a really common shared experience among young gay men or male-presenting people. Where you meet somebody significantly older than you that just seems to check off all of the boxes. And somebody, most of all, that you want to get through experiences with. And what I mean by get through is you have a checklist of things that you have to do when you're 16 years old, or in my case, 15 years old. And that's suck a dick and have some fun. And I found somebody that was willing to take that energy out on me. I was 15, he was 25 years old, and hey, I heard the oof in the crowd, and that is very, very real, but not in his defense, because I will never defend him, but I initiated a huge majority of it. I was playing a game, participating in Ludus. Ludus is game-like love. It's based around being able to get an advantage over the other person, trying to make sure that they feel more for you than you feel for them. And your love is based around the activities, the things that you do together, rather than actual aspects of their personality.
Woo!
I met him when I was doing a production of Hairspray, again, in Evergreen, Colorado. I was one of the darkest skinned people that they could find. And besides, actually, any of you guys know the drag queen Zara? First drag queen I ever met, and she played Seaweed, which is a very, very sexual straight male with a lovely thick layer of lip gloss on the entire time.
Yeah.
But I met him during this production, and he would drive me home all the time. He introduced me to what weed was like. We talked a lot about theater and about what it was like to be so scared and young and gay in a high school that he'd actually gone to. And things just kept going from there. We spent the entire summer together, peaches and all, just like in Call Me By Your Name. And eventually, at the end of it, the game was over. Somebody had won. I'm still trying to figure out who, but I don't think it was me. And I kind of realized after that that it set a precedent. A precedent that I wrote here in my notes. It set a precedent and it sealed it with trauma. From then on out, my relationships would play out with a sense of fun and a sense of trauma, or a sense of despair and predestiny, whatever was necessary. The feelings of others were not to be taken seriously, and my own feelings even less so. Every love from there on out could only be held and compared against a facade of a relationship, a cheapened, dirty board game version of one. Luckily, this has faded with time and experience, and I've softened up the love that I do share with people, all of the boys that I mentioned today, as well as every single person in between. But anyways, here is my self-indulgent, sad love song for the night to go with this last half of my romantic history.
Woo!
And funny enough, this song actually played a role in two of those relationships, because when I want to woo somebody, I use my only asset, my voice. Yes, I do. I believe that one day I will be where I was, right there, right next to you. And it's hard, the day just seems so dark. The moon, the stars, they're nothing without you. Your touch, your skin, where do I begin? No words can explain the way I'm missing you tonight. This emptiness, this hole that I've inside, these tears, they tell their own story. Told me not to cry when you were gone. But the feeling's overwhelming, it's much too strong. Next to you.